God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth does change, and though the mountain be shaken into the heart of the seas. For this God is our God forever and ever. He will be our guide even unto death. If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not also give us all things with him? It is God who justifies. Who is there to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised from the dead, who is at the right hand of God, who intercedes for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? So tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Let us pray. Eternal Creator, whose days are without end, we humbly acknowledge your presence this day as we honor and celebrate the faithful lives of our passing brothers and sisters. We pray that your presence also abide with the family members and friends who grieve, that they may find comfort in your promised peace. Amen.
Burial detail, attention.
We are gathered together to honor Chief Quartermaster Gary Max Sutherland, U.S. Navy veteran who fulfilled 24 years of honorable service. He was born on the 22nd of February, 1955, and enlisted in the Navy from Grants, New Mexico. The son of Marvin and Joyce Sutherland, husband of Rose Conta, and father of Holly Sutherland. He completed his life's journey on 27 June 2016 in Aiea, Hawaii. Unto Almighty God, we commend the soul of our departed Chief Quartermaster, Gary Max Sutherland, in sure and in certain hope of the resurrection unto eternal life. Promised through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, we commit his body to the deep. Amen. We are gathered together to honor Chief Boatswain Mate Henry Warren Welsh, U.S. Navy veteran who fulfilled 27 years of honorable service. He was born on the 3rd of May, 1946, and enlisted in the Navy from White Bear Lake, Ramsey, Minnesota. He served in the Vietnam War, where he was subsequently awarded a Purple Heart and a Combat Action Ribbon. He is the son of Dana Patterson, husband of Akayo Welsh. He completed his life's journey on the 15th of April, 2017. Unto Almighty God, we commend the soul of our departed Chief Boatswain Mate, Henry Warren Welsh, in sure and in certain hope of the resurrection unto eternal life, promised through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, and we commit his body to the deep. Amen. We are gathered together to honor Yeoman First Class Gordon Edson Stewart, U.S. Navy veteran, who fulfilled 10 years of honorable service. Today, he will be committed to the deep with his wife, Mrs. Dorothy Stewart. He was born on the 10th of June, 1927, and enlisted in the Navy from Lynn, Massachusetts. He married Dorothy Lee Stewart, and together they had a daughter, Linda Stewart. Dorothy completed her life's journey on the 15th of October, 2007. He completed his life journey on the 17th of March, 2017. Today, they are reunited. Unto Almighty God, we commend the soul of our departed Yeoman First Class, Gordon Edson Stewart, and his wife Dorothy, in sure and in certain hope of the resurrection unto eternal life. Promised through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, and we commit their bodies to the deep. Amen. We are gathered together to honor Signalman Second Class, Kenny C. Charles, U.S. Navy veteran who fulfilled 3 years of honorable service. He was born on the 11th of April, 1925, and enlisted in the Navy from Boston, Massachusetts. He served as a submariner and fought in World War II, where he was awarded the American and the Asiatic Pacific Theater Campaign Medals and the World War II Victory Medal. Upon his honorable discharge, he served the city of Boston as a firefighter. He was the husband of Christine Kinney and the father of Michael Kinney. He completed his life's journey on the 9th of January, 2016. Unto Almighty God, we commend the soul of our departed signalman, second class, Kenny C. Charles, in sure and in certain hope of the resurrection unto eternal life, promised through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, and we commit his body to the deep. Amen. We are gathered together to honor Mrs. Kayoko Cole. She was the wife of Chief Warrant Officer Robert Melvin Cole, U.S. Navy veteran who fulfilled 28 years of honorable service. Kayoko was born on 6 December 1934 in Gumakin, Japan. She married Robert on 26 December 1967 and joined him in the arduous task of being a Navy wife for 23 of his 28 years of service. She completed her life's journey on the first day of April 2017. Unto Almighty God, we commend the soul of our departed, Mrs. Kayoko Cole, in sure and in certain hope of the resurrection unto eternal life, promised through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, and we commit her body to the deep. Amen. Eternal Father, your spirit hovered over the waters at creation. You delivered your children through the waters of the flood, and by your Son's word, you calmed the stormy sea of Galilee. As we have committed the earthly remains of our brothers and sisters to the deep, we pray you will continue to grant them peace and the joy of being in your presence for eternity. We ask this through Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, and all are invited to pray with me in unison.
Burial detail, hand salute. Dismissed.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first